Hey everyone, what's cracking my dudes? What's flipping my eggs? I'm Alfian Poon, I'm your host for today. Joining me is John Paul Poe.
Yo, what's up? It's been a while.
Yes, it's been a while.
Haven't seen you playing.
Yes, I've been busy doing other stuff.
Oh, that's good, man, that's good.
Yes, doing
Monster Hunter.
Yes, playing Monster Hunter World, grinding the HR, and slaying the monsters. Oh, look at the screen, right? Don't look at the screen.
Hey, look at the screen.
Yeah, look at the screen. So, Ikai here. Oh, is he playing Dredge? Yeah. Oh, Dredge.
Is that? Oh, he's trusty
Merfolk. Hey, speaking to the right. Oh my god. Oh, here comes Smuggler's Copter. Turn 2 Smuggler's Copter.
It's okay, you can come if you want. I'll just sit down and chill.
Why do you want to sit down and chill? Come join us.
You need to speak into the mic, John.
I am speaking into the mic.
That's not the most interesting thing.
I'm touching the mic.
You need to speak in the, it, more in.
Speak more in.
Yes, speak more in. That's what you call it.
That's not the most interesting thing. Like, turn 1, the opponent had like 2-4-1 in the bench line. And his opponent had like 1 flutter chance.
That's what you call fair magic.
Yes. Fair Magic, clearly the name of the game here in Modern, as Hafiz is going to bring in Silver Guild Adept. Doesn't seem like Hafiz is in a bad position though. Ikai only has 2 creatures on the board, and Hafiz is going to crew the Smuggler's Copter up, going to loot and scoot, discarding the Etherval. Yeah, Ikai goes down to 16. And here comes Spraying Seas onto the Copperline Gorge. Hafiz obviously more interested in the draw rather than turning it into an island, because Ikai already has the mana, already has the color fixing from that 1 copper line gorge he has. Not sure why he drew there though. What do you think, John?
Actually, I don't know any that much cards in Modern since I'm a standard player, so so I have no idea.
Seems legit. Okay, so Ikai going to swing in with the team here, bringing Hafiz down to 15. And here comes... Ooh! Okay, no. Gorari Tuck. Oh, Curse Catcher. Haha. But, Ikai, I think he's more interested in putting the cards in the graveyard rather than drawing 3 cards. Although drawing 3 cards probably would have been much better for him in this case. So Hafiz untaps here, gonna go for the draw. Looks like Hafiz's plan here might be to race Ikai before he's able to amass a critical state on the board.
I think in this matchup it's a race already.
Yeah, looks like a race. Does Hafiz have any lords in his hand? Here comes Silver Guild Adept. Gonna reveal Curse Catcher. Gonna draw a card. Alright, gotta crew the Smuggler's Copter and swing in for 5. Oh. Draws and discards the Etherval. Ikai gonna dredge. Oh, Nakamiba! Oh, dredge for the loan. Two Nakamibas!
That was a good dredge.
That was very talent. Much talent. Very skill.
I don't have the talent of drawing cards ever. I remember playing the Unified Modern here. Uh-huh. Yeah, and I was running my good friend Conrad's Boggles deck.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I always bring down my opponent down to 3. Always. But I can never ever draw Rancor, Grip's Wound, or what's that, Spirit Mantle to push in the finishing damage ever.
Oh my god. Sorry, bro.
Yeah, I know. I don't have talent.
You're not talented enough. Try again.
Maybe I should, like, what? Join you here more often?
Yeah. Maybe if you come here more often, you can learn how about... Look at people fail so you don't have to fail yourself. Okay, so gonna swing in with two here. Bring Hafiz down to 10. Oh, it's also gonna Faithless Looting.
Faithless flashback Faithless Looting.
Alright, seems like a plan. Oh, you're gonna dredge life from the low. Ooh! Very handsome, so talented. Very, very, very talented. Nakamiba gonna go to the field, I think. Yeah. Yeah, three flying Nakamibas. And a copper line gauge.
Ikai's hand is all lands.
Yeah, it might be all lands. But Hafiz here gonna flash in something. A lord? Nope, that's not a lord. Oh, that's no, Harbinger of Tides. Gonna bounce the price amalgam. Which actually Ikai can cast because of the spreading seas.
Free blue mana.
Yes, and he just needs to tap black with the gemstone. Yes, he did cast it, he dredged it.
Okay. And Hafiz bounces his...
Ooh, this is a scary bot.
What's that zombie again? The blue-black...
Price of Elgo, Price of Elgo. Okay, so... discards the Spreading Seas.
Oh, that's a very scary board.
Yeah, Hafiz's board very big right now. Four Merfolks with one Law of Atlantis. Just gonna zerk into Ikai. Ikai needs to probably block one way or another with the Nakamibas. Yeah. No, that's Mirror Ridgery. So, yeah, Mirror Ridgery is the one that gives all the Merfolk's Island Walk, while Law of Atlantis just buffs, I guess.
Oh.
Yeah, let's check it out. Oh wait, no! Law of Atlantis is the one that gives Island Walk.
Yeah, I'm quite sure that most of the lords...
Ah!
Isn't
wait, no, you can't block!
Yeah!
Can't block, bro. They have island walk. They walk on your islands.
They have island walk.
They have island walk.
Oh, I think somebody have to. It's basic. He can block the smuggler's copter to.
He can block the smuggler's copter.
But I think the other three he cannot block.
Okay, so that's Silvergill Adept is 3-6.
Nine, I think.
3-6. This is lethal. The.
No, he's 11. He has to block the Smuggler's Copter.
Wait, Silver Guild Adept is what toughness? 1?
2-1.
Yeah, so that's 3, 6, 9, and the Curse Catcher is like...
No, the Curse Catcher activate the...
Oh, okay. Oh, wait, then that's a mistake actually. He should just swim with the Curse Catcher. Oh, whoops. Whoopsie. Oh, maybe he just played the Curse Catcher this turn. Alright. Yeah, okay, he probably played a Curse Catcher this turn. So, yep. Ikai, very bad spot right now. Fortunately, Hafiz is kind of tapped out. So, Ikai can swing in with both Nakamibas here.
I mean, the but...
Ikai has to go for the Conflagrate kill here. Oh, he's counting.
That's Conflagrate in his graveyard.
Okay, he's gonna dredge with Life on the Low. Mountain, Price Amalgam, Stomping Grounds. Okay. Not very impressive. Oh, you did get the Price Amalgam in the graveyard, so that's pretty good.
But he has to do the Conflagrate route.
Yeah, he kinda...
Or else he's... I don't see him winning already
at
this point.
Okay, so what can Ikai do here? I think he's out of outs actually. Okay, he's gonna leave behind the Nakamibas for some reason. He's probably gonna I don't know. Yeah, I don't know. He's just gonna swing with the Blood Gust though. So bringing Hafiz down to 8 if Hafiz wants to let this through. Which
I think what does the conflict does again? I forgot.
Okay, let's get conflagrate up. So conflagrate deals X damage divided as you choose among any number of target creatures or players. So flashback red discard X cards. Does Ika have 8 cards in his hand?
No, I don't think so.
Well, it doesn't everything. Then he makes 6 cards. So he judges like the life, he judges the dark, and he judges whatever in his hand and try hopefully. Right?
Yeah, so
yeah.
He's gonna cast life from the loam. I don't know, man. Doesn't look like. Okay, so Hafiz is considering sacrificing the curse catcher to counter it, but doesn't seem like he will do that. Instead, Ika is gonna get a lens back from Life from the Loam. I don't think that's enough. I don't think that's 8 cards in his hand. Oh yeah, it's sorcery. Yeah, he has to play. Okay, so conflagrate.
I think what he can do now is just try to get rid of.
Yeah, get rid of
the Lord.
Get rid of the Lord. Get rid of as many creatures as possible. So he's gonna. I don't know.
He threw away 5. 5 cards, I think. 5 cards, 5 or 6 cards.
Okay, so he's gonna. 2 damage here. 1 damage here. Another damage here. 2 damage there. Yeah, that looks like what he's gonna do. And Hafiz says, wait! I'm gonna flash in another lot.
I mean, if Hafiz in another lot, then it would be pretty bad because then he would definitely kill last time, right?
Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay, so Ika here playing to his outs, almost destroying entirety of Hafiz's board. Oh, here comes. Huh? Wait, how did you attack? Why did he just bounce the Nakamiba?
Yeah.
Huh?
Hey man, I don't know. I actually really don't.
Yeah, little, right? He just bounced the Nakamiba. Okay, hold on. Let's. Harbinger of Tides. Oh, let's be tapped. Okay, so it's not that Hafiz is a bad player. It's that we are bad commentators. Okay.
Yes, we don't know the cards.
Yes,
you should know the cards, Alvin.
Yeah, I should know the cards.
You have Google right here in front of you.
No, it's not Google. Yeah, I think Ika is dead. What can he possibly draw? Yep,
he can't draw anything from that position.
Yeah.
He should probably give back the. Yeah, okay.
Like, the only thing he had was to, like, hit one more card to, get the conflagrate. Because he only missed one point of damage. If he attacked with one, that could be enough.
Yeah. Oh well, after game 2.
So
both players
he
shuffling
hit
up.
Attack with all of his creatures. He brings down Hafiz to 7. Then
he was at 8, so he
was 8? No, he was at 10.
Yeah.
So he just attacked with Blood Gust, bringing down Hafiz to 8.
Yeah.
If he attacked with all of his creatures, so that would bring Hafiz to 6.
Yeah. He
so he had
only for 5.
For 5. Oh.
Yeah, he was missing one card.
That's quite true.
But I mean, he planned it such that he knew that he couldn't get lethal. So he killed a lot instead, which gave him quite a chance. But I mean, Hafiz had more merfolks and stuff as well.
Yeah, Hafiz didn't really draw dead that time. He had some good stuff in his hands. He played Merfolk after Merfolk after Merfolk, and then into Lord, and then into some Harbinger of the Tides and bounce stuff. And yep, Ikai just did not manage to find a footing in that game. But both players going to sideboard here. What do you think they're going to sideboard in?
Really, dude, I don't know anything about Modern that much.
God damn it, John.
I know.
Anyways,
I think what does Merfolk usually have in the sideboard? Maybe some graveyard hate for Merfolk or something?
Yeah, maybe Abdul might have Graf Digger's Cage for Ikai here. Graf Digger's Cage and some other Nihil spell. No, this black. Need black for that.
What's the tombstone looking?
Relic of Progenitus?
Yeah, Relic of Progenitus.
Tombstone looking card.
Sorry guys, I really don't know magic anymore right now.
It's quite appropriate because it's like kind of tombstone card. Right?
Tombstone card.
It's been a while since I've played a lot of magic.
It's okay, I mean, everybody gets busy once in a while.
Like what my colleague always says lately. Or have been saying lately, life is so hard.
I don't know. I when I start working, I'll let you know.
Okay. John Paul, can you speak to the mic? I'm trying to test the mic.
Why are you trying to test the mic?
I don't know.
Did you break the mic?
Nope, the mic was very broken.
No.
Yes.
I'll tell Mick about it. Mick.
Oh no.
You watching this, Mick? You listening to it?
Nope, he's not. Oh man. Oh wait, it should be round two. This is not round one. This is not round one. This is round two. Man, I'm hungry. I could really use a cheesecake. I feel like eating a chocolate cheesecake right now.
Don't talk about food, man. I haven't eaten dinner yet.
Oh, why?
I don't know. I wasn't that hungry.
Now you're hungry though.
Now I'm hungry since you're mentioning about chocolate cheesecake. You know, with those cheeseburger and fries.
Oh yes, cheeseburger and fries. I'm on a diet today.
Since when were you on a diet?
I don't know. Do you know diet has the word die inside?
Yeah.
That's literally the first three letters. It just spells out die. So if you go on a diet, do you just die?
Not really.
Really, really, really gets the noggin jogging, if you get what I mean. Anyways, you guys done with his shuffling. Abdul still shuffling.
Both players are shuffling.
Yeah, they're still shuffling. Did they even sideboard any card? I did not see them put in any cards from the sideboard. That's how little attention I'm paying to the stream right now. Because what am I gonna do when they're sideboarding? They're not playing the game. They're sideboarding.
This is what you call fair game of Magic Modern.
Yeah, this is. To be fair, this is a relatively fair game of Magic. No turn 3 Khan. No turn 2 Grape Shot for a million.
Mean turn 2 Grape Shot for a million?
Yeah, I don't think that's possible. Is that possible?
Turn 3.
Can you turn 2?
If you have the very perfect hand, I think.
I think you need like...
You have the perfect hand and you draw from the Mana Morphos all the cards.
Yeah, so what you need, right? Mana Morphos...
Basically, it's a turn 3 kill.
No, Mana Morphos... Metamorphose into a ritual, and then you have three mana. Then you play a discounter. Then you go off from there.
Yeah,
that's turn 2 kill, man.
Yeah, that's the turn 2 kill. But you have to have the perfect hand.
You could have the perfect hand.
Not only a perfect hand, but the perfect draws also.
Hey, man, that's not out of the bounds of reality. Wow. Okay, Dagmar Salvage. Stick with him. Gonna dredge again. Oh, Conflagrate. Oh, another Stinky. Oh, Price Amalgam. Oh, okay.
And there's another one. Why didn't he?
I think, no, he drew all his cards already.
Oh, he drew all. Oh,
yeah. Okay. You only draw 2 from Faces to Thing. You don't draw 3. Come on.
Sorry.
Drawing 3 would be a bit broken. Here comes Silver Guild Adept. Gonna show off the Pearl Master of the Master Pearl Trident. Play. Yes. Okay, gonna dredge the Stinkweed Rib, I think. Okay, dredge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Nope. No hits. Wow, Ikai is not... This is not his route. This is not his game, man. He dredged so much this game. Look at the pile of cards over there. Look at it. Look at all the cards. He has not had a single hit from all those cards.
Except for... Oh no, he has one... What's that?
Price of Melgo. Yeah, and you can't get it up because you need
You need the Blood Gust to come.
Yeah, you need a Blood Gust. You need like a Necromoeba. You need something, but he's just not getting it. But he's gonna fetch with the Bloodstained Mire. Gonna bring him down to 17. Maybe he's gonna flashback the Faithless Looting. Yes, yes. Okay, so bring back the Stomping Ground, flashes back the Faithless Looting. So one thing that he has going for him is that he has a lot of cards with the word Dredge in the deck, in the graveyard, which is the deck's namesake, of course. Dredge, because you want to dredge your entire library to the graveyard so you can destroy your opponent. So Abrupt Decay, Faithless Looting. Oh, Narcomoeba. Copland Gorge. Oh, two Narcomoebas. And here comes another Stinkweed Imp. Price of Melt. Okay.
That's a good one.
Okay. We seeing some colors now, boys. And he has lots of cards in his hands. So, yes. Oh my god.
That's three Price of Melt in the graveyard.
Oh my gosh. Oh boy. And he has so many cards in his hand for the conflagrate. Ikai just dredging like a god here. Half his draws. Not sure what he's able to draw to save him from this onslaught of dredgy dredge. Wow, dredge looks like a fun deck. I think I want to play dredge now.
Yeah, you quit playing your 8 rack.
I had to sell my Lilianas for school supplies.
Oh.
Yeah.
No wonder I saw all your Lilianas on the auction.
Yeah, man. School supplies.
Stay in school. It's cool.
Yeah, school is cool. Stay in school, kids. Don't drop out of school to play on the Magic Pro Tour. Don't do that. Only idiots do that. Yeah, but anyway, Hafiz at 3 mana, but not sure what...
I don't even think he has anything to deal with this board on this... What turn is this? Turn 3?
Yeah, this is turn 3.
Yeah.
And, my god, Ikai has Conflagrate in his hand. In his graveyard, Lightning Axe. Oh my god, he's just gonna... Oh, he's gonna dredge again. Oh my god, dredgy dredge. Copland Gorge. Oh, Blood Gust. Oh, 2 Blood Gust. Oh, Nakaviva. Oh, 3 Blood Gust. Oh, everyone's a winner. Ding, 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 ding.
He's dredging like a pro.
Oh my god. This Ikai is very handsome. Is he single?
Why are you asking me that?
He shouldn't be single because he's very handsome.
Alfred.
He's gonna swing it with all. He's gonna swing with the entire team here. So, Hafiz. Not sure what Hafiz should do here. He's gonna block.
He's gonna trade with the...
Lightning Axe. Oh no. Discard Stinkweed Imp. Destroy your Pearl Trident guy. And that's a lot of damage. That's 9 damage. Oh, 10, 10. Oh no.
3, 6, 9, 10.
Yeah, it's 10, right? And here comes... yeah, I think Hafiz just scoops it up, man. Look at that board. And look at
He dredged like a pro on this round.
Yeah, man, Ikai is a dredge god. Holy shit, that's a good ass draw. Ikai still counting if he has lethal here, but
no, he has lethal.
He definitely has lethal.
Hafiz put in blockers.
Yeah, doesn't matter what Hafiz puts, he's just gonna conflagrate it to death.
No, I don't think he even needs to do conflagrate. That's
2, 4, 6. Yeah, he has
9, 10, 11, 12, I think.
Hafiz just... I think he's giving up here. He just passes the turn to Ikai. And Ikai's gonna untap and swing with everything. He's gonna dredge with the stick with him though. So put that in his hand. Deck one salvage, Insulin Unit, Blood from the Loam, Cough My Gorge. Another blood gas. Let's just put another blood gas just for good measure. The three blood gas he milled from that one card was not good enough. Let's put another one.
But it doesn't have haste.
Yes. So yep, full swing here, and Hafiz just scoops it up like he should be. That was a very entertaining game of Magic.
That is what you call fair game of Magic.
Yes, very fair. To be fair, if Hafiz was playing black, he could have had Damnation. And if Hafiz Damnation the entire board, it wouldn't matter at all, because all Ikai had to do was just drop a land, get his blood gusts and fry some amalgams back.
Yep.
Oh my god, this game is hilarious. Anyways, you're watching More Than One here at Grow Games. I'm Alfian Poon, I'm your host. Joining me today is John Paul Poe.
Yo.
And we're watching Dredge versus Merfolk. The blue variant, not the shitty green blue one. The blue variant.
Oh, is there green blue in Modern for Merfolk?
Some people tried, they failed.
Oh, maybe because the pilot wasn't Hafiz. From what I know,
no, Hafiz tried green blue version.
From what I know, Hafiz is the only Merfolk player here.
Yeah, but Hafiz tried the green blue version before.
Oh, but that was in Standard.
No, he tried it in Modern too.
Oh,
he didn't like it. Let's just keep it that way. He didn't like it.
I don't think there's anything worth splashing in for the green in Modern if you're playing Merfolk.
Yeah, that's you.
And you already have more than enough lords for.
Yeah,
the
do you really need another lord in the form of Miscloak Herald?
No, right.
You have enough lords.
You have more than enough to win the game.
Yeah, man. Okay, so Ikai left the table here. He's taking a piss, I think. Abdul, he didn't go his sideboard, so he must be content that his current configuration is good enough to go against Ikai. That means either Hafiz does not have Graph Digger's Cage or
Relic of Progenitors,
or he just not draw it, which is the more likely scenario. He's not talented enough to draw it. What's this? What's this Gachapon here? Interesting.
So yep, I think Ikai went to the toilet and...
That's not Ikai, that's...
Oh.
That's an uncle. Oh my god, I'm really hungry. I'm so hungry.
Please stop talking about food, Alfian. You're making me hungry also.
Yeah, same.
Now, should I even play the last round?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I should.
You can just split the last round and get two packs.
No, I need the points.
Oh, then split for packs and play for points?
Yeah,
that's what everyone does.
Trying to grind the last, 16 points just to get for the monthly...
You know what you should do? You should come for Standard Showdown. Standard Showdown is the easiest way to get points.
Really?
Yeah, dude. 4-0 gets you 8 points.
Oh.
3-1 gets you 6 points.
Oh, don't worry. I'll come down for that one.
I come up for that one too. Because I also need points.
Currently at what point?
I don't know. Last time I checked, I was at 15. But I think I should be all the way up to 20 plus right now.
Last time, before yesterday, I was at 9 points. Then I came down to play Standard. Luckily, went 3-0.
Ooh, so talented.
That's 5 points? For you? Standard, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so right now I'm standing at 14. So I need 16 points just to barely get in the... free invite.
Wow, John, you're very talented. 3-0. How are you 3-0?
That was lucky, event? Actually.
What you play? What deck were you playing?
I'm testing Sultai Midrange.
Sultai Midrange?
Deck provided by Reeve.
Reeves?
Yeah, Reeve Chia.
Oh, okay.
He actually went final, he went to the finals twice with this deck on PPTQs, but sadly he said he keeps losing to mono red with the deck.
Lol.
But I won against mono red with it yesterday, so maybe I was just really lucky.
Or maybe you better player than Reef Chia. You considered that?
No, I still consider him a better player.
Yeah, he's probably better than both of us combined. Actually.
Yep.
Like we both could be placed a game against him and he would still win.
Oh yeah.
With blindfolded, of course.
Yep. I remember every time like we catch up to, you know, if we're both planning to play on the same PPTQ. What we usually do is like come in early, do some playtesting, and then every time we do a playtest, he always complains that I bully him during the playtest. Then on the actual rounds of the matches, I'm the one who keeps losing and he's the one winning.
That sounds like a lot of games.
So it's like I don't know. I don't know if I'm that talented in Magic, so.
Oh, speaking of talent, we see Ikai busting out the talent again. Let's see what he measures. Oh, nope. Oh, okay, that's okay. But he still has two more cards to draw, so
yeah.
Just dredge more. Nope, that's okay. Nope.
Yeah, oh! There's like 3 amalgams in the graveyard and a blood gas, so.
Okay, he still has one more draw though. Okay, let's do the Gokari Tuck. Okay, let's see what he gets. Flip it up. Oh, wow. Okay, so all he needs is a land. If he gets a land, he's very handsome. Oh, he's so handsome.
It's a...
The whole crew of Price Amalgam is out. We have John, John's dad, John's mom, John's brother, all here. And their cousin, Bloodgas. Oh my god. Ah, shit. Oh my god. Ikai is so talented at the game.
And that's so ugly.
It's so talented. So much talent. Ikai is so talented. Dredge. Dredge looks like fun. Oh, bounce one of the Fries of Algorithms. Boohoo. He's gonna let that resolve. Okay, let's bring up Kira. Kira, the glass speeding dude. So Kira, great glass spinner. Creatures you control have, whenever this creature becomes a target of a spell or ability for the first time in a turn, counter that spell or ability. So Ikai's removal not gonna be very good here unless he has two. Yeah, here comes the team though. Gonna swing him, bring him down to 14. Here comes Curse Catcher, just for the insurance plan. Ikai gonna untap. Untap.
I think this one basically is already a race.
Yeah, but this looks like a race that Ikai might be winning actually. Because...
most likely, yeah.
Yeah, he has so much on the board, and the only way he can go is up. He's gonna dredge more cards. And here he goes, dredging left from the low. That's Nakomiba, that's Stinkwave, that's another Bloodgas. He goes, oh my god, Nakomiba goes onto the field. And all he needs to do is just fetch with the Bloodstained Mire to get that that Bloodgas on the field. But he probably wants to dredge some more to see if he's really that handsome, can get more Bloodgas into the graveyard.
No, I don't think he needs to fetch just to bring back the Bloodgas. He can wait for a while until like, you know, to trigger again the Price Amalgams. If ever Hafiz able to bounce them back or whatever.
That's true. Okay, so Hafiz here, big trouble. Ikai gonna swing in with a bunch of stuff. Here comes Life from the Loam, gonna take back some lands, gonna fatten his hand a bit so that his conflagrate is a bit more scarier. Oh, that's a lot of cards in his hand. Most likely his conflagrate is gonna go to face though, because if he targets a creature with the conflagrate, it's not going to go through because Kira, the Great Glass Spinner, is gonna counter it. So takes Wooded Foothills, Mountains, and Stomping Ground, puts them into his hand, and he passes the turn, I think. Quite unfortunate though that Ikai did not manage to get Hafiz down to 10. Otherwise, Ikai's Blood Gust would have haste, then that would be really good. Mountain and get the Blood Gust back out and pass the turn. Actually, Ikai might have wanted to play the Lightning Axe
just to get
the
amalgam
in the graveyard. Yeah.
And then play a land to bring both back.
Yeah, that's right. That's what I was thinking. But maybe Ikai has other plans. Maybe he wants to save the Lightning Axe for removal, because you do need two removals for the Kira. So Kira's gonna swing in here. Rest of the team probably gonna stay on blocking duty. Ikai goes down to 12. And Hafiz, is he gonna pass the turn? What? He just passed the turn here. Probably gonna... Hafiz only has two cards in hand. Ikai has a million. Literally a million cards in his hand. Hafiz looking at that one card very intently. Ikai gonna dredge out with the Stinkweed Ape. Ah yes, Jason is right. He shouldn't have played anything. He was at 8 cards and could have discarded the Amalgam and brought it both back with and the Blood Gust end of the turn with the fetch. Jason,
true.
Very experienced dredge player. But Ikai's turn. I think he dredged out the Nakamiba and Nakamiba came out. I think he's swinging with the whole team here. Yeah, should low.
Yeah, I think he should swing.
Yeah, he should go for the win here. He has the conflagrate kill. Just swing the whole team, man. Come on. Turn it all sideways. Then Clawcraft conflagrate the face. Yes, that's right. Turn everything sideways. That too.
Leaving
the Nakamiba behind for some reason. But it's okay. I think he should have enough for the conflagrate. Right? So this is three.
Unless Hafiz is going to block with both of his creatures.
Oh no, he's gonna flash in something. Okay, so he's gonna flash in his hand.
He's gonna flash his hand saying I concede.
Yeah, you can't really do anything against Ikai's draw, man. That was insane. That was very, very insane. Very nice. Hafiz so wrecked by Ikai. Ikai so talented. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching One and More Girl Games. We'll be back after these ad breaks and in about 15 minutes for round three.
So we'll be... No, actually, Alfian's gonna buy me some dinner. So
no, I'm not.
Thanks, Alfian, for the dinner in advance. So do come by here at Grey Ogres sometimes.
Yes. Come by at Grey Ogres Games. If you're watching the stream and you like to want to support us, head on down to the Grey Ogre Games eBay shop. Let's get that link up. www.ebay.com/Grey Ogre Games. Buy our cards, make us rich, and then we'll open another shop in Malaysia. Probably not.
Really?
No, I was joking. We're now going to open another shop in Malaysia. Anyways, we'll catch you guys in a bit. I'll see you. Bye.